As of Wednesday, Lake Mead was about 28% full, with the elevation of about 1,045.04 feet, according to Bureau of Reclamation Public Affairs. Overall, we currently stand at about 0.3 feet higher than originally projected in December. As of Thursday, Lake Mead has risen another fraction of a foot to 1,045.25 feet above sea level. Over the past few weeks, recent storm events and runoff into the tributaries that enter Lake Mead, as well as reduced releases from Hoover Dam, due to a decrease in downstream demand, have had some impact on the lake's elevation. While the amount of precipitation received in the lower basin and from tributary inflows helps, rainfall from recent winter storms, alone, isn't enough to offset the decades-long reservoir declines. The majority of water in Lake Mead, a reservoir on the Colorado River, comes from snowmelt in the Rocky Mountains, which is off to a great start this winter. The lake's water levels have been declining for years, but last year was particularly prominent for the drought-stricken reservoir, as it reached an all-time low. In July 2022, water levels were at 1,040 feet, the lowest they have been since the reservoir was first constructed in the 1930s. Lake Mead's water level stands at 1,045 feet as of January 8, 2023. That's 21 feet lower than the levels recorded at the same point in 2022, and 38 feet lower than the same point in 2021. The lake supply isn't just important to surrounding communities for water, but as it's also formed by the Hoover Dam on the Colorado River, which generates electricity for thousands of people. If the water levels continue to decline, the consequences could be catastrophic. It currently appears to be hurtling towards deadpool level, which is at about 895 feet. At this level, water wouldn't flow past the dam anymore, meaning its operations would cease. Scientists are predicting more of the same in 2023, so the situation is likely to get even more dire. Federal agency the Bureau of Reclamation predicts that Lake Mead could reach 1,013 feet by 2024. In a worst-case scenario, Lake Mead could reach as low as 992 feet by the end of July 2024, according to a two-year probabilistic projection of the Colorado River system by the Bureau of Reclamation, released in August 2022. The water isn't just declining, it's also barely filling. The Bureau of Reclamation, the federal agency that manages the Colorado River, projects that by the end of 2023, Lake Mead will drop another 20-30 feet, meaning the reservoir would be down to around 21% full, Pitt said. It could drop even lower. Reclamation may need to keep more water upriver in Lake Powell, because the Glen Canyon Dam could be damaged if the water level there gets too low. Lake Mead's water levels fluctuate naturally with seasonal weather patterns, but with the ongoing drought, these have been harder to predict. There has been less rainfall and not as much winter snowpack flowing down from the mountains. Occasionally, water levels rise with an onset of rain. For example, lots of heavy rainfall has been sweeping across Nevada and California in recent days. But climate change worsens conditions, and scientists believe that more is needed than just relying on unpredictable weather patterns. Lake Mead's water levels have been declining since 2000. It has gotten warmer and drier, and the rules haven't changed fast enough to stop the decline, Pitt said. The legal framework is really complicated, but it's urgent to change it right now before the risk increases, and there's no water for everyone and everything dependent on water from Lake Mead farms, birds, major cities, really all life in the Southwest. Lake Mead isn't the only river experiencing the severe effects of drought. The wider Colorado River source is also drying up, making Lake Mead's situation worse. The river is one of the most important across the southwestern United States and northern Mexico. It provides water for around 40 million people in the surrounding areas, and supplies water to 5 million acres of farmland. Over the last century, the river's flow has dropped by 20%, according to data from the U.S. Geological Survey. Parts of the Mississippi River is also the lowest they have been in a decade. Particularly low water levels have been recorded in Memphis, Tennessee, where levels have dropped to as low as minus 6.1 feet as of November 15.